tell you what I did. I just cut a couple pieces of 15 inch. It's 15 inches long, and it goes across, and I'm gonna weld them directly to the passenger seat pedestal. So that way it'll bolt into the floor with all the factory mounts, and I'll still have the sweet motorhome seats. Fitting a welding mask over these dreadlocks isn't easy. Your seat mount done. This is what it looks like. The driver's side is going to be a little bit more difficult because it was a bench seat. So one side, the side against the door on the left side, is this size, this high off the ground, off the floor. But this side, for the driver's side, it was way over on the tunnel over here, so it's about half as tall. So I'm not going to use that. That'll take a whole lot of work. Get it to weld in bars and everything, and raise it and everything. So I'm not going to do all that. But if you look, wait, I don't know if you can see. Hold on, let me walk around here. If you look right there, that is a GMC Safari. I haven't checked it yet, but hopefully the seats, the pedestals will be about the same. I don't know if they will be or not, but hopefully they're the same height and have similar spacing for the holes where they mount to the floor. And this is the motorhome seat mounted in the truck. It's a little high, so I'm gonna have to come up with a plan to lower it without redesigning everything. I don't know how I'm gonna do that yet, but it's just a little bit too high up, so that's gonna have to be modified. This is the factory seat, a factory seat, and you can see it's that much lower than the motorhome seat over there, so I'm definitely gonna have to do some work. And this side over here, I'm going to have to completely build mounts to mount it. I may do the same on the other side and just complete ditch the factory mount seat pedestal and just build my own mounts.